You are welcome once again to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for taking time to subscribe, to follow, to share. Thank you very much for coming back to watch this second series. You know, I started this series in the last class where I told you I was going to be sharing on 10 silly reasons or 10 stupid reasons why some people get married. The first silly reason why people get married is to have children. It's to have children. I've seen people get married because of just one thing. I want to have babies. Especially people who grew up in a home where they seem to be like the only child or two children to a family in the to the parent, or a family of only boy, and is the only boy. So the parent told him, get married quickly, we want to see our grandchild. So you just grab your copy now, you get wedded, and everybody donates money for your wedding ceremony. Always remember, so many people help you plan your wedding, but it's your responsibility to plan your marriage. You understand? So many people got married last week, Saturday. Today is Monday. See, all those friends, all those family members are gone. It is now their responsibility to plan their marriage. So you need to sit down and at least borrow yourself some sense. Don't allow anybody to push and tell you, we need to see our grandchild. I need to carry a baby girl. I need to carry a baby boy. You know, you're the only baby boy in this family, and make sure you give me boys, boys, boys. And that is why people get married, and when the lady comes back from the clinic, the laboratory, and say, doctor said we are expecting a baby girl, the guy is depressed because he has been told by the mother, it is a baby boy I want. Now, your wife and yourself cannot manufacture children. No. See, all these ones, doctor will say, well, you do it this way, you do it this way, X chromosome, Y chromosome. Hello, doctors will just give you advice based on their own professional idea, but God is the manufacturer of children. I always say it this way: God promised us fruitfulness, but He did not promise us 9 months. He did not promise us that in the next 9 months you're going to have your child. So don't kill yourself. Don't kill yourself. Don't go into marriage because you want to have babies. Let me tell you the truth. The reason why some people are frustrated in marriage today is because they came into it for the wrong reason. And when your reason of getting married is wrong, the result you're going to get from that marriage will be wrong. That marriage is not first of all for making children. There are so many people who do not have a child today and they are fulfilling purpose. Pastor Gentle, are you saying children are bad? No, children are the heritage of God. So it gives it at its own time. You can't force its time. And if you get it outside its time, you are getting it from the wrong source and you are going to pay dearly for it. So please don't come into marriage just because you want to have a child. Number five reason why people come into marriage, very stupid reason, very stupid. Stupidity in capital letters. Stupidity written in gold. The fifth reason why people come into marriage is to prove a point or to revenge. And I'm going to explain what I mean. As a counselor, I had the privilege of sitting down with people who went through a major heartbreak. They've been in a courtship for 4 years. All of a sudden, the guy or the lady came and said, I'm sorry, I'm no longer doing. And the whole empire crashed. The guy was like, how on earth, what would I tell my friend, what would I tell my colleagues, what would I tell my parents? And at the end of the day, 4 years of his life, 4 years of our life went down like a house of cards. So at the end of the day, the next thing I saw the guy in my office was, Pastor Jethro, I'm here to tell you that in the next few months I'll be getting married. And I'm like, oh boy, what are you telling me? 2 months ago, you were in my office crying like a baby. I remember I still gave you tissue paper to wipe your face. Tell me what said, you know, that girl that left me is getting married in the next few months, and I don't want her to get married before me. So I want to prove to him that if she left me, God has not left me. Hey! Can you see that, Rema? You know, that's deep. You know, as a counselor, I listen to things, I be like, are you right? Do you see how your sense is working? I've seen people, I've seen ladies who went through major heartbreak, who went through major disappointment, and just to prove a point or to revenge, they went ahead to get married to one of the friends of the guy who left, just to prove a point. And at the end of the day, you see, when you get married to revenge, marriage has a way of revenging on you. when you get married to prove a point, marriage has a way of proving a point to you that you were wrong. See, that guy has done his point, his side. The worst he can do to your life, he has done it. Don't allow a guy to push you into everlasting regret, because when marriage is wrong, it can hinder you from making heaven. It has been proven today that women have more women are more hypertensive. We have more women who are hypertensive than men. And one of the reasons is because a woman measures the quality of her life by the quality of her relationship. So when something is wrong with her marriage, with her relationship, it affects her health. And that's why before you know it, she's taking, she cannot sleep, she's eating, but she's getting slim, she falls into depression, her blood surges up, and before you know it, the guy that gave her high blood pressure is fine with another lady, and this girl or this lady is cheating hypertension. You need to be very careful. If somebody disappoints you, if somebody left you in the midst of your life, you started courtship at 26 and now you are closer to 30 years old and this guy left you, hello, he has left you, but God has not left you. Glory to God. He has left you, but that is not the end of your life. Are you getting it? Please don't allow the society to tell you that you are 35 years old. And because that guy left you, just grab your copy, pick anybody, prove to him, prove to her that you are not old school. Prove to him or her that you cannot be left alone. Hello, don't get married because you want to revenge. Don't get married because you want to prove a point. Do you understand? Virtually most of, in my own counseling clinic, most of the people who I know who got married to prove a point, at the end of the day came back crying. Because when you carry the mindset of revenge, it will block your senses from thinking right. When you carry the mindset of revenge, I'm going to show him, I'm going to show her, instead of concentrating on the right thing, you'll be thinking about the wrong thing. You just want to prove a point. You just want to show him. You just want to show her. Hello, your life is too precious for you to enter into a competition to prove a point. Are you getting it? Your life, your destiny is too precious for you to enter into a relationship just to prove a pointer to somebody because of something he did or something he did not do. Hello, there is more to your destiny. So the fifth reason why people come into marriage, silly reason, stupid reason, is to prove a point or to revenge. Number six. this one will make you laugh. People come into marriage because they want to change their name. Mm-hmm. Especially ladies, I just want to change my name. My name is Mrs. Bella. So I just, this Bella, I've been bearing Bella for 30 years now. When will my name change? When my status change? They have been calling me in the office, Miss. Even my junior, at least I'm assistant manager in my office. My colleagues who are even 3 years down the ladder, they are calling me Miss. When they are already Mrs. So I am Miss. So what is missing in my life? Hello, ma. When they call you Miss, it's not because something is missing in your life. When they call you Miss does not mean there is something missing in your destiny. Miss is not your destiny. It is just an addition. Something just been put there to qualify the married from your marriage. That is not you. Are you getting it? They look at you and they call you Mr. So they say, no, it's not Mr. It's not married. And you are dejected. You are sorrowful. Why? Hello, what they call you should not define you. Your results, your assignment should define you. I've seen people come into marriage just because they want to change their name. Guys come into marriage just because they have been told that until you are married, you are not responsible. So he wants to prove to the society that he's responsible, then he gets married. Only to get married and discover that he has not actually prepared for marriage, then irresponsibility of the highest order begins to show from his life. Stupidity of a first class level begins to emanate from his life because he came into an institution he was not prepared for. Don't get married because you want to change your status. in the community, in the estate where I live, everybody's just when they are going out, they just bring their children to come and stay with me. So when will I be free of this? So I will just get married. So at least I too will be in their shoe. Hello, you will be in their shoe and you will cry like some of them. You will be in their shoe and you will get the same result they are getting. Are you getting it? Don't get married because you want to change your name. Mm-mm. Don't get married because you want to change your status. I now want to be Mrs. And do you know that's the reason why some of our ladies look for a wealthy man to marry, so that when they call me with the name of that man, it is prestige. Hello, that's not prestige. When they call you a name you did not have, you will lose it with time. So it is better you hand your wealth, you hand your reputation, and not just go and borrow somebody's name and put it in front of your name, and you are floating around with the ring, and you understand, you are just saying, I am not Mr., I am not Mrs. Hello. Marriage is more than that. So people get married because they want to change their name or change their status. That's point number 6. Now let's go to point number 7. Point number 7. How? This does not actually make sense, but it is something very, very common, which I know you must have heard about, or you even have people around you that are falling into that trap. Oh God, this is very pathetic, because as I'm about saying this, I have stories to back up with this. I have experiences. I have people that have counseled that fell into this trap, and I'm going to give you some stories along this line. The 7th silly or stupid reason why people come into marriage is to get the greener pasture. They want to get married so that they can get the greener pasture. What, Pastor Jeff, what do you mean by to get the greener pasture? Are you saying we must just stay in this lower state? No, we must advance. But don't advance through the wrong method. Don't advance using the wrong approach. There are some people who are married today who got married because they were in a relationship with a guy. I remember vividly, there was this guy, he's not married, the marriage is more than 5 years, and I don't know how far this guy is feeling. Very wonderful brother. I met him in a church where I went to minister. It was a singles summit, a singles conference, and I was there first year, I was there second. I think I was there in their fellowship for more than 3 times, and very wonderful guy. All of a sudden, we got close, and I just suddenly got to know that he was planning to get married. I called one of his friends. Why is your friend rushing into marriage? And he said, Pastor, let me just confide in you. My friend is in a relationship with a lady, and the parents of this lady are based in the US. So, and one of the conditions they are giving to her is that if she's going to join them in the US, in the States, she must be married. And our friend, our brother, got to hear about it, and our brother just glued to that sister. And guess, in I think 3 months, they got married. Now, just to get the greener pasture. Nigeria is this way today, but it will not always be like this. Things will change. Are you getting it? Don't get married to a guy just because he wants to travel out, and they say they need a marriage certificate, and you just get married to him, you get married to her, and off you go. Hello, there is more to your life than going to US. There is more to your life than going to Canada. Canada is wonderful. US is wonderful. But hello, who tells you that in the next few months, in the next few years, you cannot even sponsor yourself? God is not asking. Pastor, tell us. Why should we get married? You've been able to show us silly reasons, stupid reasons, why people come into marriage. So tell us, what is the main reason why we must come into marriage? Get ready for the last section. Get ready for the last video in this series. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, click on follow so that you can get our notifications anytime we are online. And also make sure you share with your friends. If you are in a relationship, make sure your partner also listens to this. Make sure your partner watch this.